A very pleasant good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Motorsports Magazine from the Airborne Speedway in Plattsburgh. Week number one of the 2008 season on tap tonight. Rob, the highlight of the card, 50 laps for dirt car modifieds.
Rick, opening week, there's always a lot of excitement through the garage area. Teams have been working through the winter trying to get their cars ready. And as you said, 50 laps tonight for the modifieds. And we expect our quick early stroll through the pits. A lot of very competitive cars in the garage area already. And we expect a very good field of the modifieds. Of course, some of the fine drivers back from last season, the defending track champion George Foley, Patrick Dupree, who we heard from on our opening show, our opening edition of Motorsports Magazine last week, Mike Bruno back with the Crickets 22, and some other new drivers that we haven't seen before. Alain Boisvert was actually a track champion up in Quebec at Granby and in Cornwall, Ontario. He was a track champion at two dirt tracks last season, so he will be here on a regular basis, and I wouldn't expect him to take too long to really get a hang of the asphalt and for him to be challenging for wins as well.
We've certainly got excellent weather conditions for this first week of the season. Temperatures in the mid-60s, a little bit of a wind, but nice sunny skies.
Well, you always keep your fingers crossed. You never know what Mother Nature is going to throw at you when you're racing early in May, but hopefully we'll have these nice conditions stay through the racing card. We're expecting that to happen, and again, it should be a very exciting night.
Coming up on the program this evening, we'll be showing you one qualifying event from the modified division, the Sportsmen, the Renegades, the Warriors, and the Bombers. And we'll show you one feature in its entirety and the closing laps and victory lane from the other features as well. And Rob, one of the things that we've seen in practice, and hopefully it's a good indication, those fields are going to continue to grow throughout the season in the Warrior and Bomber divisions. They've got a lot of new cars and new faces this year.
Well, let's face it, Rick. What puts people really in the stands more than anything else is good competitive car counts. And last year we were blessed throughout all the divisions to have pretty good numbers. And we're hoping for more of the same this season. When the more you got out there, the more competitive the racing usually is. And we're hoping for that in 2008.
I'll throw in two or three driver interviews as well. And we certainly hope you enjoy this episode number one of the 2008 season from the Airborne Speedway in Plattsburgh. It's Motorsports Magazine coming to you from Airborne.
Welcome back to Motorsports Magazine, joined now by Sportsman driver, one of the most popular drivers here from the Northern Tier, Jamie Bigor. Jamie, last year, second place in points. You chased that number 79 of Jason Bonnet through the better part of the season. Talk about last year and evaluate how things went for you here.
Last year was a good year. We started off not so good the first race of the year. We had a distributor problem that put us dead last to start the year off with, so we fought back and made our way back up to second at the end of the year. So the big picture was it was a great year.
I was looking back at last year's results a little bit earlier in the week, and I noticed that really the opening week was the poorest finish for you through the season. And it really goes to show you how the type of competition that you have in that division, you really got to have your game going each and every week, and one poor finish might have been the difference in you winning a track championship.
Yeah, that's it. I mean, every week, you know, you have to finish these races. It's so important. There's 8-10 guys out there that can win the race any given night. Very competitive.
Talk about your mount for this year. Anything that you did differently to the car? Talk about your expectations going into 2008.
Over the winter months, we brought the motor back over to get refreshed. While that was gone, I actually found a new motor for sale that had six races on it. So we jumped on that, and we put that motor in the car, and it seems to be working out well for us. And we have the spare that we ran last year at home in the garage all freshened up, ready to go if need be.
Talk about your plans for 2008, running regularly here every Saturday night.
That's the plan, every Saturday night here, you know, shooting for another, you know, a championship, of course. But if we can have a year like we had last year, that'd be great too, so.
One of the things about the Sportsman division, we said you got to be on your game every night. Size up the competition that you'll be up against this year for us.
Oh, there's, like I said, probably 7, 8, 9 of us that can win this. You know, we've got the 79 of Bonnet and Toby, Liberty, Buckle, Robin. There's a field full of us that are very competitive and we all want to win. So, you know, during the week, we got to take the extra time and put it into the car and, you know, come here with our best equipment that we have and, you know, race hard as we can and hopefully end up towards the front at the end of the night.
We, of course, see you here at the Speedway on Saturday nights. Tell us a little bit about Jamie Bigor away from the track, family, and other things that you have going on in your personal life, other things that you're into.
Yeah, actually, we just run a family hardware store in Moores called Bigor Supply, family-owned and operated, myself and my parents. Some of the other hobbies, we just got a boat last year at the end of the year, so we enjoy that on Sundays when we can. But other than that, racing and you know, working at the family hardware store.
Well, we'll look for you here on Saturday nights, and we wish you the best of luck in 2008.
Thank you.
That's Jamie Bigor, everybody. He's in the Sportsman division, the number. All right, welcome back to Motorsports Magazine, and joining me now is the defending track champion of the Ernie's Discount Tools Modified Division, that's Saranac Lakes' George Foley. And George, last year, I think particularly for the first three quarters of the season, you were a model of consistency in this division. Talk about how the car went for you last year, and try to sum up for us your 2007 season, a track championship here.
The car was real good most of the year, and it just got lucky a lot, really. Just stayed out of the trouble, and with the other guys not being here, we ended up winning the championship. But I mean, we had 7 or 8 second place finishes, so we were there. It was just closing the deal, you know.
Now, as the down the stretch, especially the last quarter of the season, there was a lot of bad luck, a lot of mishaps on your part. You had built up a pretty good cushion in the points department, but you really had to sweat things out down the stretch.
Yeah, it's I try not to race for points because it ends up causing headaches and problems, and we just had a lot of bad luck at the end of the year. That's all.
And now in 2008, you look forward to another season. Talk about your plans for 2008 in regards to Airborne.
Well, we're going for a double negative here. We took green, which is a bad luck on a race car, and put it with our normal luck, and we're going for a double negative. We're going to turn it around and be a good thing.
And you're hoping, of course, to run here on a regular basis on Saturday nights, and perhaps you're talking about double negatives, maybe a double positive, and then is double up perhaps as a track champion, although that would be very difficult to do with the likes of the competition here.
Yeah, it's real hard. Our car is real fast, though, so we're happy, and we're not thinking there's any issues. It's just a matter of being out of the problems and a little bit of luck. We'd like to finish another championship, but we want to win some races this year and not follow around. You know, second's nice, but it's still second.
You've been in this division now for several years. Talk about the level of competition. It has increased year by year. Go back a few years, there were 5 or 6 cars that might end up in victory lane. Last year, there were 6 to 10, and now you got some other guys that are coming in and they're going to be here on a regular basis. Talk about the competition and how you've had to step up your game and your team has.
We actually went, and because of the people that are here racing and the level, we took this winter and had our motor gone through and actually changed it. There's a gear rule this year, so we actually changed the motor to run better at a lower level, and we're ready.
2008, again, you talk about that competition, and you're certainly going to have to really put things together night in and night out, and we wish you the best of luck as you are the defending track champion, looking to make it back-to-back. Good luck with that.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
That's George Foley, everybody. He's the defending track champion here at the Airborne Speedway. Stay tuned for more Motorsports Magazine. Joining me now on Motorsports Magazine, he's the defending track champion in the Warrior Division. It's Rick Doner from Clintonville, New York. And Rick, last year the car was very fast for you, consistent throughout the season, and you really have to be in a division where there's a lot of really good runners.
Yes, the car handled awesome last year. I'm just hoping that it does it this year. And they made me change the motor halfway through, and it seemed to go, I think, better, to tell you the truth. You know?
Right.
You know, I won the following race, and it seems to handle twice as better than all these other cars. I don't know if I just doing stuff right, or
I know there was some discussion last year about the motor. Just give us a little background on that. You did change the motor, and then as you mentioned, it really didn't seem to make much of a difference. Talk about what you went through last year in regards to that motor.
Okay, it was a 2.3 motor. They come dual rack cam in these cars, the 2.3 and 95, and they didn't come with a single rack cam. So as I was playing by their rules, I put the single rack cam on top of the dual overhead cam motor. What you said was fine, as long as it didn't have beat the compression ratio, but you didn't. So I raced the full, you know, half the season, and people started didn't like it too much. So they made me change it to a 2.2, and I think it went better, to tell you the truth.
So going into this year, talk about the car that you've got underneath you, what you've done to it over the off season, and what you're looking forward to in 2008.
Well, if I'm making a top 5 this year, I'll be very happy. You know, it's got the same motor, just a different cam in it. Hoping she's just a little bit faster out of the corners. That's all I'm looking for.
And I've noticed a number change. It was the Deuce last year, and you've gone to number 95 with a Lightning McQueen scheme.
Yeah, my daughter wanted me to change it, so I had to go do it.
So she won out on the 95. That's the reason for the 95 number change?
Yeah, all the kids, they come down to me at the stands and stuff, and they would say, how come it's 2, not 95? You know, so that's the reason why. She's 95 this year.
Well, we wish you the best of luck in 2008. It's going to be a difficult task with the competition in the division to try to repeat as the track champion, but I'm sure you're up to the task and looking forward to the challenge. Best of luck.
Thank you. And it's going to look really tough out there this year.
That's Rick Doner, everybody. He is the defending track champion in the U.S. Army Warrior Division. For Daniels and Ledoux in row number 5.
Field picks up the pace coming off of turn number four, and another Saturday night of stock car racing action is under green. Davies on the inside, Haywood on the outside. Nick Haywood trying to get a good bite off turn number two, working on the outside, running the rim to the lead. Haywood the leader, Davies to second. Danny Dubuque running to third spot. Lonnie Rivers working on the outside of Dave Raptoy as they joust for the third position. Lap number one to be led by Nick Haywood. Kenny Davies runs second. Side-by-side battle for the third spot. Dubuque on the inside, Rivers on the outside. He's got third off turn number two. Dubuque trying to fight back on the inside. Dave Raptoy runs in the fifth position. Side-by-side for six, it's Brian Rogers in the 12th. There goes Dubuque up the track. He's going to lose several spots in the 61 as he lost traction and drifted high. Three wide on the front stretch. Down the front stretch. Mike Chris threading the needle. The Ledoux 47 on the inside. Joe Daniels picking up a spot. But Dubuque in a 61 goes from fourth to dead last. Up at the front, here comes Lonnie Rivers putting on a charge. Rivers on the seven, looking to the outside of Kenny Davies in the number nine. Nick Haywood is the leader. Davies on the inside has second. Lonnie Rivers wants it. Still working on the rim is Lonnie Rivers, running in that third spot. Dave Raptoy, four car lengths back, sitting in the fourth spot. And it's Brian Rogers running fifth in the Schwann's 12. Side-by-side battle continues for the second position, and we're halfway. Nick Haywood by a car length drifts up the track though in turn number two. Here comes Davies with an opening down the backstretch, looking to take that spot away on the inside. Haywood still on the outside, driving it hard into three and four. Again shoots up the track. Kenny Davies with room on the inside is going to take the lead away off four. Lonnie Rivers working right on the back bumper of Kenny Davies, giving a little push down the front stretch. Rivers to the second spot. Haywood fighting an ill-handling race car that's pushing up the track. He's back to third, and now here comes Rivers for the lead. Lonnie Rivers dives down to the inside of Kenny Davies. He'll take the lead into turn four. Lonnie Rivers, the new leader, with two to go. Lonnie Rivers with a Chris Construction 7 showing the way. He's got a half-car length lead over Kenny Davies. Then it's three car lengths back to Nick Haywood. Haywood still with his hands full with that number 29. Dave Raptoy looking to move up with the 21. Raptoy running in the four spot, but it has room on the inside as they race to the white flag. Good battle for third with Raptoy on the inside. Haywood trying to hang on to a top three run, working on the outside. Brian Rogers has a good view of it sitting in the fifth spot. But out front, Lonnie Rivers now with a two car length advantage over Kenny Davies. Here comes Rivers off of turn number four, down the front stretch. He's going to get the checkered flag. Second to Davies, third to Raptoy on the inside, fourth to Haywood, Rogers fifth. Sixth is going to go to Randy. As the Adirondack Auto pace car ducks to the infield, Kane and K.A. in row number two, McNeil and Tisser in row three. Rushlaw on the 21, and Woodruff in the 55 in row four. Here they come, picking up the pace, green flag! Alan Barber on the inside, Dupree on the outside in the 24 of the Outback car. Sideways down the backstretch. Barber leads him into turn number three. Here comes the pistol. Dupree working on the outside, running the rim, trying to take the lead away. Off turn number four, it's a drag race to the stripe. Barber had the lead at the stripe by about 3 feet. Here comes Dupree back on the outside. Down the backstretch, Dupree still working a rim in the 24. Wavier on the inside. Dupree coming back after him. Seesaw battle for the lead off turn four. Down the stripe. Dupree's got him. Almost dead even at the stripe. Wavier in the 73 takes the lead back off turn number two. Dupree into the second spot, still on the outside. K.A. running third. Andy Kane running in the fourth spot. Here comes Dupree back on the outside. He's got the lead this time. Patrick Dupree trying to finish the pass. Off turn number two and down the back stretch, the Outback car has the lead. Alain Boisvert running second, third Chris K.A. Andy Kane is fourth. The Ellenberg Express for McNeil running in the fifth spot. Patrick Dupree picking him up and putting him down now at the front as he is opening it up early. This time by chief starter Weasel Bruno shows them that they are halfway. Here comes Dupree halfway. Dupree by half a straightaway over Alain Boisvert. Third, Chris K.A. Francis McNeil, fourth. Richard Tesser to the fifth spot. Andy Kane stuck on the outside. Here comes Mike Bruno. Bruno working the inside to sixth. Matt Woodruff moving up a spot. Mike Rio trying to move up as well with the 0-2. Patrick Dupree at the front running away in the first qualifier. Alan Boisvert is hanging on to the second spot. Chris Kaye running third. Francis McNeil still fourth. Richard Tesser in the anti-strategate number 49 runs into fifth position. Two to go for Patrick Dupree. Here comes Richard Tesser to the inside of Francis McNeil. Tesser backed out of it. Might have been a little bump down a backstretch. Now Tesser drifts high, and that opens the door for Mike Bruno. Bruno will pick up a spot. White flag on the field. Your leader is up in turn number four, setting a blistering pace in his first qualifier and serving notice is Patrick Dupree. Dupree wins it. Second, it's going to be Alain Boisvert in the 73. Third to Chris Kaye. Fourth to Francis McNeil. Mike Bruno, fifth. Richard Tesser, sixth. Matt Woodruff, seventh. Mike Rio, eighth. Ninth, it's going to be Andy Kane in the 27.
Forks now driving the number 95. Five rows back, John Bradley in the 77. Outside, Bobby LeVere in the 5. Shotgun on the field, Matt Brusso in the 26. We are under green. Twaits on the inside, LeVere on the outside. Duval sideways a little bit in the 12, manages to hold on. Is on the move quickly as your defending track champion, Rick Doner. He's on the outside of the 95 and looking to get the number 3 spot as they come off turn 4. Twaits will lead lap number 1. LeVere running on the outside, grooving in that number 2 spot. McCormick inside in the 17 runs 3rd. He's got a handful. He's got Doner on the outside and Duval right behind him on the inside. St. Germain runs in that 6th spot. Chris runs 7th. Bobby LeVere runs 8th. Bordeaux 9th. Bradley is 10th. As the battle heats up for that number 1 spot. LeVere looks outside and waits there side by side off turn 2. Up the backstretch, LeVere pokes his nose in front. Twaits battles right back on the inside. Doner now has got to the inside and he'll try to take that number 3 spot. Halfway this time by Twaits and LeVere remain together. Now LeVere looks inside as they head up the backstretch. And C.J. LeVere will take the lead going into turn 3. Twaits tries to battle back, but he'll have to settle for second as Doner's on the move, gaining on the top 2. 2 to go! Now Twaits comes back on the outside. LeVere gets a little squirrely, but holds on and maintains that half a car length advantage. Doner continues to gain ground in the 95. This may be a 3-car battle before it's over. LeVere on the inside. Twaits on the outside. 1 to go. C.J. LeVere in the 4. Billy Twaits outside in the 69. And Rick Doner on the inside looking for room. 2 turns left in this first qualifier for the Napa Warriors. C.J. LeVere off turn 4, down the stretch to the checkers, will win it. Twaits gets the second spot. Rick Doner, 3rd. Kenny St. Germain, 4th. Dustin Duval will finish.
And shotgun on the field in the Reeds Speed Shop. Number 00 from Plattsburgh, Chris Reeves. Green flag. 8 cars taking the green flag in the second qualifier for the J&S Steel Sportsman Division. And Bucko Branham shows the way with the number 20. Jamie Beagle running in the second spot with the number 19. Jimmy Bushy to 3rd. Mike Shagnon stuck on the outside is drifting backwards. Bushy with a wiggle in the 4. Here comes Toby Ebersole. Toby Ebersole looking to grab the 3rd spot. They run door to door into turn number 2. Bushy again is sideways, hanging on to it. And Toby Ebersole is going to take 3rd. Here comes Tyler Terry with a 44. Terry trying to take the 4th spot away. Bushy right now hanging on to the 4th position, but he is still hanging on to the outside. He's going to go back to 5th and get the car down on the inside where it seems to be a little more comfortable. Skip Liberty to the sixth spot in the 59. Here comes Chris Reeves in the double zero, moving up as well as Mike Shagnon goes back to the final spot with the number 86. He'd been pinned on the outside. Buck O'Brien out front with the Northern Sanitation number 20. He's got a six-car length advantage over Jamie Begor. Begor very loose that time off of turn number two. He lost several car lengths to Branham as that car drifted up the track off the second turn. Begor is second. Ebersol running third. And number 20 had two wins last season in the sportsman division. Begor's number 19 had three wins, second most in the division. Toby Ebersol, as we mentioned, in the 82, had one win last year, and it also came on opening week. Halfway for Buck O'Branham. Branham leading by half the backstretch over Jamie Begor. Begor's got about the same advantage over Toby Ebersol, who is sitting third. Tyler Terry right on the back bumper of Ebersol running in the fourth spot. Jim Bushy solidly in line at fifth. And it's a gap back to Skip Liberty in the 59, who is running in the sixth position. Seventh is Chris Reeves in the double zero. Not much off that back bumper of Liberty. Now, matter of fact, he's going to move for that spot. Reeves in the double zero to the inside of Liberty. He's going to pick the spot up. Give Chris Reeves sixth. Skip Liberty back to seventh. And running eighth, Mike Shagnon with the 86. Two laps to go this time by for Buck O'Branham. Popsicle sticks are out. Here he comes off of turn number four. Two to go for Branham. Branham, Begor, Ebersol, Terry in the 44, and then Bushy in the 11. Ebersol a little loose that time off turn number three as Terry moved to the outside. Might have been a little bump with Tyler moving to the outside, trying to get that third spot, but as he goes to the outside, here comes Jimmy Bushy trying to take fourth away from him. Tyler Terry was running fourth behind Toby Ebersol, looked to the outside, and he perhaps will end up losing that fourth spot. Checkered flag is out. Buck O'Branham's going to win it. Branham with a solid drive. Second's going to go to Jamie Begor. Third, Toby Ebersol. Fourth to Jimmy Bushy. Fifth to Tyler Terry. Chris Reeves, sixth. Skip Liberty, seventh, and eighth is going to go to Mike.
Garrett will start inside row number three. Three flying is out. Fire number two. 19 is Brandon Allen. The six, Brock Begor. The 93 is Eli Bischoff. The 08 is Alex LaPlante. The 23, April Bordo. And the 66, who just kicked up the dirt over to number two, is Steve Miller. Back at the rear of the field, the 21, he's got Gary Frederick is your leader in the 01.
Running in that number two spot, it's the 43.
Josh Terry, those two cars have opened up six car lengths on the number three spot, and Randy Guerin's 84. Brock Begor's B6 running in the number four spot. Eli Bischoff's 93 looks inside as the black flag is out on that eight car. Bischoff again looks inside. Brock Begor, who's on the outside, as they both try to get by the 84 of Randy Guerin. Good battle for that number three spot as Gary Frederick in the 01 and the 43 of Josh Cherry have started to pull away. Now those three cars close in on the number two cars. Looks like Terry's in trouble in the 43. Car momentarily lost power up the backstretch and he dropped way back. Guerin goes around in the 84 car. He spins it to the infield. Will stay green, two to go. Gary Frederick Jr. in the 01, and now Brock Begor is second. Josh Terry runs third in the 43. Not for long, here comes Eli Bischoff in the 93. Bischoff takes third on the inside. Terry back to fourth. Bert Drake runs fifth. April Bordo is sixth. White flag after Gary Frederick Jr. in the 01. Brock Begor sixth. He is in that number two spot. Bischoff runs third in the 93. Terry fourth in the 43. And Bert Drake holding on to that number fifth spot with the 05. Checkers are going to come out this time by, and your winner is going to be Morrisonville's Gary Frederick Jr. He takes the second Monster Energy Drink Bomber qualifier. Brock Bigor comes home second. Eli Bishaw gets the number three spot. Josh Cherry fourth. And Bert Drake rounds out the top five in the 0-5. Scott Richner getting together with a 66 of Steve Miller as they come to the checkered flag.
Four, then it's Mike Chris at the 8. Chris Frenier in the 93, the 46 for Little Joe Daniels, the 3 for Joe Warren, Cody Kilburn in the 32, Keith O'Neill in the 0, Dan Dubuque in the 61, Bob Dragoon in the 36, green flag. Lonnie Rivers in the number 7, leads him off turn number 2. Rick Hart in the deuce going with him on the outside. Hart working on the outside, thinking about maybe getting that car down to the inside, but Kenny Davies sticking his nose up there in the number 9. Davies trying to make a bid for second. Lonnie Rivers in the 7 shows the way. Black flag out for Danny Dubuque in the 61. He's trailing smoke, and he'll head back to the garage area. Rick Hart able to get that car down in front of Davies into the second spot. Ed Doner working on the outside of car number 1. He's trying to move up to third. Kenny Davies has that position. Lonnie Rivers in the 7. Two-car length advantage over Rick Hart. Kenny Davies running third. First feature event of 2008 for the Versatile Trailer Sales Renegade Division. And Rivers has a two-car length lead over Rick Hart. Still side-by-side for third. Here comes Davies surging off turn 4. Right now, Dave Raptoy holding on to the 5th spot. Lance Raptoy working on the outside is 6th. But Nick Haywood is right there with the number 29 working on the inside. The 1 of Ed Doner, the 11 of Lance Raptoy. They've been stuck on the outside since the drop of the green flag. Lonnie Rivers in a 7. Rick Hart in the deuce. It's been about a car length. That's the advantage for Lonnie Rivers, and that's what he's been able to maintain over Rick Hart. Then from Hart back to Kenny Davies, it's about 5 car lengths. Then a car length and a half back to Raptoy in the 21. Here comes Nick Haywood looking at the inside of Raptoy for the 4th spot, but Raptoy was able to get the car down on the inside into turn number 1, thus holding off Haywood into 29. Rivers is the leader. Hart runs 2nd. Davies running 3rd. Dave Raptoy runs 4th. Nick Haywood is 5th. Lance Raptoy is 6th on the inside. Then it's Ed Doner, 7th and a 1. Look out, up against the wall, making contact with the wall. Randy Ledoux, little hot off the 4th turn, but bounced off the wall, coming down the front stretch, keeps her going. Still working to the outside of Brian Rogers. He said Lance Raptoy is 7th. Brian Rogers is 8th of the 12. 9th is Randy Ledoux in the number 47. You can see the racing scar on the right side of that number 47 Ledoux's car where he made contact. Meanwhile, up front, challenge for the lead. Rick Hart had a peek to the inside of Lonnie Rivers at a turn 3 and 4, but Rivers was able to close the door. Rivers hanging on to the top spot. Now Hart's going to go to the outside. Here comes the deuce. Rick Hart bidding for the lead on the outside off of turn number 2. Lonnie Rivers is able to hold him off to now. Hart still looking to the outside, now dives it back down to the inside, seeing if Rivers will drift up the track. Won't do it. Lonnie Rivers hanging on to that lead. Lonnie Rivers is the leader. Rick Hart runs 2nd. Kenny Davies is running 3rd. 4th is Dave Raptoy. Nick Haywood working on the outside right now is 5th. He's trying to challenge for that 4th position on the outside, surging up into turn number 4. Nick Haywood may get that 4th spot on the outside. He will. Rick Hart right on the back bumper of Lonnie Rivers out at the point. Hart looking high into turn 3. Now drives it again back down low, trying to surge, anticipating Rivers slipping up the track, but it's not happening. Lonnie Rivers with a good line off 4. Lonnie Rivers leads Rick Hart. Then it's a considerable distance back to Kenny Davies, who's holding down 3rd. Nick Haywood really seems to have that car much better hooked up in this feature event when compared to the qualifier earlier. Haywood is moving to the front on the outside of Kenny Davies. Nick Haywood trying to grab the third spot away, and he's doing it on the outside. He's got it down the backstretch. Let's see if he can make it stick into turns three and four. Haywood in the 29 is up to the third spot. Davies drop kick back to fourth. Nice job by Nick Haywood working on the outside to pick off cars to get into the top three. Let's see if he can run down the likes of Rivers and Hart, who run at the front. Lonnie Rivers and Rick Hart still running 1-2. Let's try to work through the field. Lonnie Rivers the leader, Rick Hart second. The 29 of Haywood is third, Kenny Davies is fourth. The Raptoy brothers run fifth and sixth. Lance on the outside is fifth. Dave is sixth in the 21. Seventh is Ed Doner. Josh Allen is eighth. Ninth is Mike Chris. And little Joe Daniels rounds out the top 10. Defending track champion Brian Rogers is 11th. Keith Helke is 12th. 13th is the 47 for Randy Ledoux. Then it's Robert Gordon 14th. Cody Kilburn 15th. Keith O'Neill is 16th. And Joe Warren is 17th. Rick Hart still trying to find a way around Lonnie Rivers. He's going to go back to the outside into turns one and two. Rivers has been able to hold him off, keeping that number seven car down on the inside. He's been able to keep the number two at bay. And Hart has made that move several times now, perhaps looking to slingshot past on the inside after fading high and then looking low. But Lonnie Rivers has not made a mistake, especially off the fourth turn. Driving at good speed, and the car is working for him down on the inside. Lonnie Rivers has not bobbled. And if the deuce is to get by, he's probably going to have to get it done on the outside. Rivers in the seventh, Hart in the deuce. Haywood is closing the gap, but he's also running out of laps. Nick Haywood in the 29 now is about seven car lengths behind the top two cars. Kenny Davies still fourth. Lance Raptoy fifth. Sixth is now Ed Doner. Here comes Josh Allen in the number 10 trailing a lot of smoke. He's up to the seventh spot. Dave Raptoy is running eighth in the number 21. Then it's Mike Chris, Brian Rogers sideways. Look out, contact over at turn number one. Bob Dragoon spinning the 36, the 47. Randy Ledoux also there, as was Brian Rogers in the number 12, and it looks like perhaps the left rear may be down on the pace. Adirondack Auto pace cars in the infield. Here they come off turn number four. Green flag. It's go time for Rick Hart. He's going to try it on the outside. They're even into turn number two. Now Rivers puts half a car length back in front. Rick Hart on the outside of the deuce. Nick Haywood trying to get himself pinned to that back bumper of Rivers, maybe trying to take away that second spot. Lonnie Rivers still showing away as Hart runs it right up to the wall off turn number four. Here comes Nick Haywood in the number 29. Haywood sticks the nose to the inside of the deuce down the backstretch. He's got second. Lonnie Rivers leading. Happy to see the battle behind him in his rearview mirror between Haywood and Hart. Haywood on the inside has the second position at the stripe. Lonnie Rivers still leads, but there's a new contender in that second spot. It's Nick Haywood in the 29. Here comes Lance Raptoy in the 11, trying to get to the top three. Raptoy, the Benora number 11, into the third spot. A lot of smoke out of the number 10 of Josh Allen running in the top five. He's fifth. Lonnie Rivers in the 7, half a car length lead over the 29 of Nick Haywood. Then it's the 11 of Lance Raptoy. The deuce for Rick Hart, back to fourth. Fifth, Josh Allen. Sixth is Kenny Davies. Seventh is Mike Chris. Eighth is Ed Doner. The black flag is out for Allen. Josh Allen running in the fifth spot was showed the black flag that time. And here comes the field running into turns three and four. Off the fourth turn, white flag is going to be out for your leader, Lonnie Rivers. Rivers trying to hang on to the lead. Haywood looks to the outside. Here comes Lance Raptoy. Raptoy going for that second spot. That allows Rivers to pull away down the backstretch into turns three and four. The 11 for Lance Robtoy, the 29 of Nick Haywood, duking it out for second, but at the point, he's going to win. Lonnie Rivers in the 7. Lance Robtoy gets second, third to Nick Haywood, fourth to Rick Hart. Josh Allen fifth in the 10, and Kenny Davies. Mike Chris, Ed Doner, Dave Robtoy, Little Joe in the 46. Lonnie Rivers started on the point, Rick, and he was able to hold off all challengers in the first.
Into that number 3 spot. Had second place locked up, but he decided to go for the win. Made a nice move on the backstretch. Lost a little bit of ground. That allowed the number 11, the Raptoy number 11. Lance gets it at number 2 spot in the Bedore-sponsored automobile. As Lonnie Rivers, in the number 7, takes his lap of honor up the backstretch. Next up on the speedway will be 50 laps for the Dirt Car Modifieds. The Ernie's Discount Tools Modifieds going 50 laps in the season opener. There he is, returning the checkers to victory lane. We'll be throwing it downstairs where Rob Knowles is standing by there.
Yourself.
All right, Rick, we're waiting for Lonnie Rivers to get out of his car. All right, folks, he's climbing out of his car. How about a nice round of applause for Plattsburgh's Lonnie Rivers? When you consider that he won the final event here in 2007 and he wins the first event in 2008, back-to-back wins on the way here for Lonnie Rivers, who started to do a strip tease in victory lane. Don't do that, Lonnie. Hey, keep your uniform on. Congratulations, buddy. But the car was fast in practice. You could see that in the last couple of weeks. And I think really the key to your drive is how well this car handled it. Stuck down on the inside. Talk about it.
Yes, the car handles very well. I just want to thank all the guys that worked in the car. Steve Pine, Leon Hendry, Chops, Chris, everybody, Joe. Everybody's helped me out with the car, and it's really fast.
You know, this means you get bragging rights over there in the garage area. And I know to you that's probably most important.
Yes, it is. Coming off last year, I won the last race, and we did a couple improvements, had the motor refreshed, and it's going very well.
Well, congratulations. You're off to a great start. Nice job.
Thank you.
Lonnie Rivers wins it, Rick. And again, as you mentioned, nice job as well, Nick Haywood.
And I think those are the 12 cars on the lead lap. Green flag. Dupree off turn number 2. Jurgen did not get up to speed with the number 17. He is headed back to the garage area with the Lake Champlain roofing modified. The Outback Steakhouse 24, Patrick Dupree, 5 car length advantage over Martin Y in the 90. Then it's 6 back to the Crickets 22 for Mike Bruno. And now Leon Gagneau in the 4 has taken a 4 spot away from El Amo there. Eaglefield Ford, Riley Ford, number 4 for Gagneau into the 4th position. And he appears to be gaining on Mike Bruno. Bruno losing ground to Martin Y in that number 90. Laps complete. This time by, it'll be 36 for the pistol, Patrick Dupree, as Bruno continues to slide back towards the pack. And Rick, look closely next time by, but check out the right rear tire on Mike Bruno's car. It appears to be going down a little bit. Check out the right rear on the 22. See, this looks a little soft. Perhaps. Here comes Leon Gagneau looking to the outside of Bruno. Alain Boisvert running in that fifth spot.
That tire definitely going down on Bruno's 22 as Leon Gagneau starts to close in on that four.
38 laps complete. Patrick Dupree has a half straightaway lead. Started on the point. Had a good draw entering the speedway. Won his qualifier, and now he is 10 laps away from winning feature event number 1. Good racing near the back of the pack. Bucko Branham and Aaron Bartomy. Both cars are on the lead lap. And you know, Bucko Branham is really showing with that number 63 that car can go. That's a good modified. With the pace that Dupree has set, Branham has stayed on the lead lap. He's doing a nice job with that number 63. Dupree working on Andy Kane, taking it right up to the wall of the front stretch. Laps are winding down. Dupree the leader. Second is Martin Roy. Third, Mike Bruno. Fourth is Leon Gagneau. Fifth, Alain Boisvert. Sixth is Matt Woodruff now. Woodruff about to take fifth away from Boisvert. Here comes the double nickel inside. He's got the fifth spot. I had to hang on to it. Sixth is Boisvert. Seventh is K.A. Eighth is Andy Haywood. Running in the ninth spot, Francis McNeil. Into the top 10, Bucko Branham. And 11th is Aaron Bartomy. Mike Riel, 12th, but he's losing a lap. Less than five to go now for the pistol, Patrick Dupree. Dupree with a backstretch lead on Martin Roy. 47 now complete for Dupree. The best battle is for the 10th spot between Branham and Bartomy. They've had some pretty good battling going on. Francis McNeil running right in front of the 63 of Bucko Branham. Two to go for the pistol. Dupree running up on the 11th place car of Bartomy in turn number four. Down the front stretch, there's the white flag. Final lap for Patrick Dupree. He had five wins at Airborne in 2007. Dupree is going to pick up win number one right here, right now. Here he comes off the fourth turn. The Outback 24 wins it. Dupree wins. Martin Roy is second. Off turn number four, third, it will be Mike Bruno. Fourth, it's Leon Gagneau. Matt Woodruff, fifth, Alain Boisvert, sixth, Chris K.A. is seventh. Here they come down the line for the eighth spot, it's Andy Haywood. Ninth, it's going to be Buck.
Now we've got the transmission locked on that 24 car down there, so we're going to have to slide Victory Lane up the track just a bit. Now let's go downstairs where Rob Knowles is standing by. Rob?
Well, the good news is the mic still works down here. Patrick Dupree unbuckling from the Outback 24 Modified. Five wins last year, one win in 2008. Give him a nice round of applause, everybody. The pistol, Patrick Dupree, a blistering pace out front, and he brings it home to the checkered flag. 50-lap modified feature event tonight. Come on over, Pat. Well, the first question is, who drew the number on the way into the track tonight? Because that person deserves a big pat on the back, too.
Yeah, actually, I usually draw horrible numbers, but I drew four. And unfortunately, George Foley drew number one, and he had some awful bad luck with motor trouble tonight. But, yeah, it sure does help starting out in the front. But, you know, Wes and Jason and everybody at the shop really gave me an excellent car today. It was working at it all day long and just got faster and faster and got us in victory lane.
Well, I'm on the impression that this team spent more time the last couple of weeks testing here than what you did in 2007, and it certainly paid off tonight. Boy, the car was just fast right off the boat.
Yeah, it was. We've not run these tires before. There's a new rule, you had to run the tires. So we had to do a lot of testing to use it, but we did.
Well, congratulations, win number one in 2008, and I know you've got lofty goals for the season, and we wish you continued success through the year.
Yeah, thanks. I hope to be here more often.
All right, that's Patrick Dupree.
Dave DeMore is in the fifth spot. Tommy Santillo is sixth with the 88. Justin Doner runs seventh in the one. Back to the green.
C.J. LeMaire runs 8th. Jimmy Collins is 9th. Shane Bombard up to the 10th spot in the 61. Jeff McCormick had some problems going into turn 2 in that 17 car. He goes to the back. The battle now heating up for that number 2 spot. They are side by side. Waits on the inside in the 69 and St. Germain on the outside. Dave DeMore right there in the 86. Those cars drift high one more time going into two like that. That might open up for the door for DeMore to get that number 2 spot. Now, right now, Donnie LeMaire making it look very easy up front, but he's got a good battle in his rearview mirror. They're going to come by to get 5 to go. 5 to go for Donnie LeMaire. Twaits is second. DeMore now runs third as St. Germain is back to fourth. Fifth spot goes to the 1 of Justin Doner. Dustin Duval runs 6th. Good battle for the number 7 spot. C.J. LeMaire in the 4. And on the outside, Tommy Santillo's 88. Now St. Germain in the 40 looks back to the inside of David DeMore. Those two are side by side for that number 3 spot. 4 to go for your leader, Donnie LeMaire. He completes lap number 12. LeMaire is your leader. Twaits is second. St. Germain third. Now DeMore is caught on the outside. And here comes Justin Doner. Justin Doner in the 1, David DeMore outside in the 86. DeMore still losing spots as here comes the 12. We got trouble in turn 2. 37 car involved. Joe Young, the 61, also involved. That's Shane Bombard.
Born website.
www.airborneparkspeedway.com. All right, 2 laps to decide it. The Napa Warriors back to the green flag. Donnie LeMaire, the 57, has that inside line, and he'll open up a half a car length. Now full car length lead up the back stretch. Twaits drops the 69 into the number 2 spot. St. Germain holds on to that number 3 spot. White flag. One to go for Donnie LeMaire. And we'll get back to back. He won the closer in 2007. He's got 2 turns to go, and he's going to win the opener in 2008. The Atkinson scrap metal number 57 comes off turn 4. He's going to win it. Donnie LeMaire, your winner. Bill Twaits second, Kenny St. Germain third, David DeMore fourth, Tommy Santillo fifth, sixth spot, the 12 of Dustin Duval, Justin Doner finishes 7th, and the LeVares will come home. Rob is headed down to Victory Lane. He'll have a word with our winner, Donnie LeMaire. Our very colorful track photographer, Mike Watts, heads down to Victory Lane as well. How about a nice round of applause for Kenny St. Germain? He brings that number 40 home in the number 3 spot. And a good run and a nice round of applause for Billy Twaits, the driver of the number 69 for second. But the winner, it's the Atkinson scrap medal, number 57, Donnie LeMaire. Let's go downstairs. Rob Knowles standing by. Robbie.
check. There we go. Hey, Donnie Lemire. Last year, three wins for you in this division. You ended the season with a win. You start 2008 with a win. Talk about the car fast right off the bat.
Well, I'm glad to be back here. It's a brand new car. I'd like to thank my sponsors, the Atkinson, Southside Redemption, and my crew, Chico, Tommy, Bud, and Richie.
Talk about the time that you put into the car over the winter.
About 20 hours.
So not that much.
No.
Well, it certainly is great to start off the season with a win. Congratulations and continued success.
Thanks.
With just inside 10 to go, let's set the field. We'll run right through it. Branham leads, Bonnet second in the 79. Third is Duquette in the 18. Fourth is Wood in the 61. Tyler Terry looking to move perhaps to the inside of Robin Wood into turns one and two. Tyler Terry has the nose underneath Wood down the backstretch. Here comes Tyler Terry in the 44 for that fourth spot. Robin Wood kicked up into the high line. Terry trying to make a pass down on the inside as they drag race down the front stretch. Tyler Terry has the nose for fourth. Here comes Jamie Bigor. Bigor looking to get back to the top five. Robin Wood still working the high side. Bigor on the inside. They run door to door into turn number four for the fifth position. Down the front stretch. Bigor has fifth. Now Jimmy Bushy trying to close up on the back bumper of Bigor. Take that spot away from Robin Wood, and he will down the back stretch. After drifting up into the turn, Robin Wood ends up losing three spots. Branham leads. Bonnet second. Third is Duquette. Fourth is Terry. Fifth now Bigor. Sixth is Bushy. Seventh is Robin Wood. Eighth is Brian Chris. Ninth is Brian McGinley. 10th, Mike Wells. 11th, Skip Liberty. 12th, Toby Ebersole. 13th, Larry Underwood. 14th is Chris Rees. 15th, Howard Stoner. 16th is Mike Shagnon. And Richie Turner is 17th. Five laps to go for Bucko Branham. Down the backstretch, Branham into three and four, maintaining that 3-5 car length advantage over Jason Bonnet in the 79. We got a yellow. Mike Shagnon has spun over in turn number two. And that brings out a yellow flag with inside five laps remaining. 21 complete showing on the scoreboard as the field works its way into turn number three. Now they start to get on it into the fourth turn. Down the front stretch, green flag back out. Branham powers off turn number two, sticking that nose way out in front down the backstretch. Bigor thinking about a three-wide move into turn number three, backs out of it. Wisely, there wasn't any racing room there. Duquette hanging on to that third spot, trying to get to the inside of Tyler Terry. Terry coming after him on the outside. Side-by-side racing for position number three. Tyler Terry sticks the nose out in front down the backstretch. Again, Bigor with a peek to the inside. Door closed into three and four. Tyler Terry with a good run to the outside. Might make that pass for third. He does. Smooth move there from Terry as he was able to work around Sean Duquette to grab the third spot. Duquette settles at fourth. Bigor still running fifth. Wood still sixth. Chris is up to seventh. Bushy back to eighth. Ninth McGinley. Tenth is Liberty. Two to go. Two laps remain for the racing veteran from Plattsburgh, Bucko Branham, maintaining a three-car length advantage. Closing it down to two is Bonnet and a turn number four. White flag unfurled this time by. White flag, one to go. Off turn number two and down the backstretch. Branham seems to have things under control as he races the final time into turn number four. Here comes Bucko Branham. Checkered flags are out. It's always popular when he wins, and he does. Branham wins. Bonnet second. Terry third. Fourth, Duquette. Fifth, Bigor. Sixth, Wood. Seventh, Chris. Eighth, Bushy. Ninth, McGinley. Tenth to Skip Liberty in the number 59. Two wins last year for Bucko Branham in that number 20. He's got win number one of 2008.
Bucko heads off on his lap of honors. He brings the number 20 home into the top spot. Rob is headed down to victory lane. He'll talk with our winner. So if you had Rivers, Dupree, and Branham in the outside groove DVD giveaway, you are a winner. Don't forget, if you want to join the contest, it's real easy to do. Just log on to OutsideGroove.com, sign up to become a member, and make your division-winning picks in the Modified, Sportsman, and Renegade division. How about a nice round of applause for Tyler Terry? He brings the 44 home in the number 3 spot. And your defending track champion, Jason Bonnet, in the 79, comes home for second. And with another strong run in the Northern Sanitation 20, Bucko Branham gets the win. Let's go downstairs to Rob Knowles. Rob?
Congratulations, Bucko.
Check. All right, Bucko Branham's out of his car, everybody. Give him a nice round of applause as he gets his first win of the year in the Sportsman Division. Come on over, Bucko. Well, the first two or three laps, you ran door-to-door with Jason Bonnet on the outside. That in and of itself has to be pretty gratifying when your car is hooked up to run door-to-door and you know Bonnet is that fast.
I was sick of running second, third to him last year, so we did our homework this year, and it looks like it paid off really good.
Talk about the winning move that you made back early in the race. Looked like he drifted up just a little bit, and boy, was the car hooked. You dove it down to the inside. There was room there, and you were able to power on through. Talk about that winning pass.
Yeah, well, Jason looked like he was loose, so he washed up the track a little bit, and my car was turning on a dime. I mean, I could see Jason in the mirror just getting looser and looser, so I just kept my line and just kept a rhythm going, and it worked out good.
You've had a busy night. Modified and the Sportsman. Talk about your night.
Yeah, the Modified, it's my brother's motor. It's a $3,000 motor, and I'm impressed with it.
You had a pretty strong run as fast as Dupree was going in the Modified. I think you ended up in the top 10, so not a bad run for hopping into that Modified, and then you get into the Sportsman, and you get your first win of the year. It's a great way to start the year for you.
Yeah, sure is. I'd like to thank my sponsors, Northern Sanitation, Liquor and Wine Warehouse, Burger King, and Marsha Holmes, and I'd like to thank my wife for putting up with this.
Not bad for an old guy.
Yeah, not too bad.
Congratulations, Bucko Branham. Give a nice round of applause, everybody.
Halfway. Malcolm Woodward looking for his first checkered flag in this Bomber Division. Brock Bigore is second. Woodard now starts to work his way through lap traffic as he's got the 0-2 of Chad Collins to get around. Here comes Martin back underneath Bigore to take second. Five to go. Five laps for me in this main event for the Bomber Division. And your leader is the 45 of Malcolm Woodard. Randy Martin is second in the 77. Brock Bigore runs third in the 6. Speedy Brissett in the 0-2. Driving Eric Riel's car runs in that number 4 spot. Eli Bischoff is 5th. One car goes around at turn number 4. That's that 0-2. The 11 car of Mike Whalen has gone around in turn 1. But so far, we stay green. The 0-2 pulls away. Now the caution will come out. And that once again will set up another shootout to the 0-2 for L Speed. Here they come. Your defending track champ runs fourth. That's Brock Bigor. Green flag is out. Randy Martin right alongside the 46. And now here comes Bigor, splitting cars up the backstretch. Bigor into second. Speedy following him through. He'll take third. Now Speedy gets high. Two to go. Randy Martin's back to fourth. Josh Lavardway runs fifth. Bert Drake is sixth. Randy Guerin runs seventh. Eighth spot goes to Gary Frederick. Chad Collins is ninth. White flag is out for Malcolm. Brock Bigor gonna try to run him down. Not closing the gap. Woodard's gonna have to contend with a lap car as he's coming off turn three into four. Maybe not. Down the stretch, checkered flag falls. Malcolm Woodard is gonna win it all. Brock Bigor gets second. Speedy Brissett comes home third, fourth spot. Goes to Randy Martin in the 77. Fifth spot goes to Josh Lavarnway. And Alex LaPlante finishes the race in style in the 08. Don't forget, next week, 5 o'clock post time, 100 laps, bring green for the late models of the American-Canadian Tour. Along with all these drivers you've seen here tonight, the Modifieds, the Sportsmen, the Renegades, the Warriors, and these Bombers. Let's go down trackside for one last time. Rob Knowles standing by to talk with our winner. Rob?
All right, Rick, we're waiting for Malcolm to get out of his car, and we'll bring him over here and try to talk to him.
Come right over, Malcolm. Come right over to the mic.
Come on over here. And Malcolm Woodward, now, I thought perhaps you had one last year, and I looked it up, and I don't think you did win one last year. This is number one, is it not?
This is number one. I had two back-to-back second place last year, and that's about all I could do. You know, it's a different car and all, and it's a lot better.
Well, the racing up front was pretty dicey, too, back and forth there, going for the lead. You got to be pretty happy.
Oh, I'm happy. I'm especially happy. My sponsor, Eugene Bushy of Bushy Auto Parts, all my family and friends that helped me out. I'd like to take a shout out to them and thank them a lot. Without them, it wouldn't be possible.
Well, congratulations. Your season's off to a great start. Continued success.
Thank you.
That's going to wrap up Motorsports Magazine for this week. We thank you for joining us. And we'd like to thank drivers Jamie Bigor, Rick Doner, and George Foley for coming on the show. And you certainly put a jinx on Rick Doner and George Foley tonight.
Don't you always blame me for everything? We just decided to interview the guys that were the past track champions. Poor George Foley never even really made it out for any type of action whatsoever. Had motor problems in practice. Got pushed out for the feature event, and the defending track champion did not start or take the green flag. So he really had a tough night, and Rick Doner broke an axle in the feature event. So a tough night for those two defending track champions. But what a great night for Buck O'Branham. Huh? He did an excellent job in the modified feature event, and then won the sportsman feature event. A real good night for the 25-year racing veteran from here in Plattsburgh.
Of course, the race you saw in its entirety, the Renegade feature, certainly a strong battle all throughout the race up front.
Well, that's nothing new from that division. There's a lot of parity in that class. We saw 13 different winners last year in the Versatile Trailer Sales Renegade division. And Lonnie Rivers really had the recipe tonight. He just kept the car down on the inside, was able to power off the turns. If anybody was going to pass him, it had to be done on the outside, and that wasn't going to happen tonight. Lonnie Rivers with an excellent drive.
We had Patrick Dupree on our preview show, and he said their goal in the season was 10 wins. And we both thought that might have been overly aggressive, thinking they'd get 10 wins, but certainly he was really dominant tonight, and it's 10 wins certainly does not seem out of the possibility.
Well, not if they keep running like that, but at the same time, it was the luck of the draw coming in tonight, and Dupree started up near the front in the qualifier. I don't recall if it was on the pole or not, but he certainly won his qualifier, started on the pole in the feature event. And Patrick Dupree starting on the pole in a feature event, it's almost lights out before the green flag even flies. And Patrick Dupree was very fast, certainly, I think, making a statement tonight with that modified win. They'll draw again in the next racing event for position, but as soon as that handicap kicks in, the 24 goes to the back, and that kind of levels things out.
Well, that's going to put a close on Motorsports Magazine, Rob. We've talked about what went on. We want to thank Gene Gagne from OutsideGroove.com, our videographer, his video assistant, Bobby Castein, and we want to thank Jimmy Watson from Watson Glass for helping us get Motorsports Magazine on the air this season.
Hope the fans are enjoying the show, just trying to keep the track on the cable airways, and hopefully it's a show that you're enjoying, and we look forward to more.
We'll be back next Thursday. Until then, for Rob Knowles, I'm Rick Knowles. Have a good week, everybody.